Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding a grim outlook for Europe written by R.K. Raghavan. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2, plus this is important for political science optional students. Now in order to understand this editorial, we need to know three things. Now the first is about what is meant by lone wolf attacks. Second, we need to understand the increasing scope of terrorism. And thirdly, we need to understand the relationship between fundamentalism and instigating terror. That is the fight between the right versus the wrong. First of all, we need to understand the lone wolf attacks. Now this lone wolf attack is a new word in the dictionary of terrorism. This type of attacks are done by individuals who have been indoctrinated by the fundamentalist thoughts. Such type of attacks require minimum of the paraphernalia, minimum of the resource, and such type of attacks, they can be planned in isolation from the parent terrorist outfits. Such type of attacks can be unleashed with a lot of ease. Now, such type of attacks, they yield a lot in terms of output. Such type of attacks have increased the scope of terrorism. Such type of attacks have made it easy for the terrorist outfits to make their presence felt in the urban metro cities. Now when it comes to this lone wolf attacks, now these lone wolf attacks, they have a relationship with fundamentalism. This is a very cardinal relationship, and this cardinal relationship has come to fore by understanding the attacks that has been done in the cities like recently in Berlin and Germany. And then you have the attack done in Nice. Then you have the attack done recently in the capital city of Turkey, that is Ankara. Now in all these cities where the terror was unleashed in the form of lone wolf attacks, this was done because of the indoctrination, because of the imbibing, because of the inculcation of the fundamentalist thought. And what is this fundamentalist thought? What is taught through this fundamentalist thought? Now, what is meant by fundamentalism? Fundamentalism basically means you are trying to make somebody believe that a particular principle is a fundamental principle. A particular principle is right. A particular principle is right. A particular principle is something that must exist. Fundamentalist thought teaches that all other ideologies, all other doctrines existing in the world are wrong. They are false. And if the false and the wrong belief system will prevail in the world, it will also endanger, it will also restrict, it will also curtail the life of the right thought, that is the fundamentalist thought. So basically, fundamentalism is nothing It is promoting that your own thought is right, and you must be protecting your thought. You must be acting like a soldier. You must be selecting and resurrecting yourself. You must be fighting against the odds. So fundamentalism promotes nothing but a war to protect your own thought. And this fundamentalist thought can have numerous bases. It can have religious basis, it can have economic basis, it can have social basis. But most of the terrorist outfits that are operating in the world these days and are being associated with lone wolf attacks, they have the root of religion lying underneath them. So there is common thing that is underlining all these attacks is the thought of fundamentalism. Now, we also need to understand how these lone wolf attacks are taking place in the metro cities of the world. First of all, we need to understand the scope of ISIS. 2 years back, the ISIS was confined just to Syria and Iraq. Off late, due to the involvement of Russia and Syria, its scope is getting shrinked. It's the Russian forces who have fought religiously against the rebels, that is, the terrorist outfits. Now, because they're losing the war against Russia, against the forces of Bashar al-Assad in Syria, they have used electronic media, they have used information technology, they have used cyberspace to spread and indoctrinate numerous peoples. They have used this technology to develop sleeper cells, another keyword. Now these sleeper cells, these people who get indoctrinated by the fundamentalist ideas are instigated, are prompted to launch these attacks. And during the Syria crisis, what we have seen is another crisis, the crisis of refugees. The refugees and lakhs have moved to the Western countries of Europe. And it is these very people, it is the liberal policy of Germany that had let the immigrants come in the mass numbers. It was the letting in of the Germany that is unleashing this terrorist and these terrorist acts. So basically, there are two ways by which the scope of terrorism has increased in Europe. One is by use of cyberspace and the other is by the refugee crisis. So it means you can get a question of how to restrict these lone wolf attacks. It is very difficult because you cannot predict the behavior of a person who has been indoctrinated by this fundamentalist ideology. It is very tough to pinpoint who has been indoctrinated. It is even difficult for their families to assess if somebody, if their peer, if their known has been indoctrinated by this fundamentalist. So what needs to be done? It is intensified surveillance that can serve the purpose. It is controlling and regulation of the cyberspace that can help. It is the countering of the fundamentalist ideology. See, ISIS is trying to indoctrinate people, but in order to thwart this, in order to stop this, in order to dissuade this, nothing is being done by the Western countries. You need to counter the wrong thought. You need to nip and bud the false propaganda that is being spread. Only this can prevent the indoctrination. Only this can prevent the lone wolf attacks. Only this can prevent the increase in the scope of terrorism. So this was all for the lecture. You can join this channel. Name of the channel is Brainy IAS. You can contact me at 845-940-000 in case you're interested in buying the classes in the form of video classes and in the form of pen drive. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.